Guys, today experiment. I have something to show you. Homemade is very simple, but at the same time very curious and necessary. You can say food for thought and it will prompt many to their ideas. Hello, friends. All components can be found everywhere, shops, old unnecessary scraps, etc. I'll start with the copper tube. The tube is 6 mm in external diameter and approximately 2 meters long. With a mandrel for it, I took a piece of pipe from a water supply system of 32 millimeters. I did about 12 to 13 turns. Optimally 10 turns. I have a whole collection of nozzles, from the smallest to over a millimeter. Bought from a welding shop. I will choose exactly what you need by experience. They do not have the same thread, the pitch is different. This is how the spring from the tube turned out. The nozzle will be at the end of the tube around here. I will cut off the tube and bend it so that the nozzle is in the center of the diameter of the coils. To be able to replace the nozzle, it will be twisted along the M6 thread. The thread in copper is cut easily. I will select the desired diameter of the nozzle and later I will seal it with sealant or tape. I bent the tube very carefully and carefully so as not to break it. Trained on small and necessary pieces. Everything turned out very well, as I wanted, and with a small margin. Welding thin brass and thin copper proved difficult, but possible. Look. Here it is, its own man's little country. This is my workshop. It is almost ready and I will show it from the inside soon. The workshop will have combined heating, we have frosts. Even my beast freezes quickly. I picked up several options as a container. A piece of pipe, an empty gas cylinder, and even a square pipe. I promised to give a review about the angle grinder. The battery angle grinder is simply amazing. Now this is my favorite instrument. Link in description. There will be two holes in the profile on the sides. I cut a 1/4 inch thread with a tap. From below there will be an exit, and from above under a small pressure gauge. The pressure gauge is only for testing. I want to see what pressure will be inside or not. There will be 3 millimeters metal plugs at the top and bottom. A piece of threaded pipe will become the neck of the tank. The entrance will be closed with a brass plug with an oil-resistant gasket. To make everything neat, I processed the blanks on the tape before welding. I also clean up the threaded trim. I want to install a valve to regulate and stop work. From two different taps I assembled one, on one side with a 1/4 inch thread, and on the other a fitting for a hose. I welded a copper tube to the fitting. It would be easier to solder. The connection will be through a 1/4 to 1/2 plumbing adapt. You could just screw it in using a high temperature sealant. I prepared everything before welding and began to weld the input and output connectors. I really enjoy my cold welding machine. But I will also need a semi-automatic welding machine. The video has already been posted on the channel. In general, sometimes you need to rest and relax from work and hobbies. The final stage of assembly. I paint with high temperature paint up to 600 degrees Celsius. The tank lid will be a regular plumbing plug. Oil-resistant rubber gasket. All I smear with an anaerobic sealant. It is applicable to both drinking water and gases, liquefied gases and antifreezes. The pressure gauge is only for experience, to find out what pressure is in the fuel tank. Finishing the assembly and will test. I will test on refined gasoline. He doesn't give a fuss. I wonder if it will work on oil and diesel fuel? Trials. It's minus 25 degrees Celsius outside, quick start with preheat. But it doesn't work as planned. But I don't give up. I went to the premises and replaced the nozzle. I also adjusted the position of the nozzle in relation to the center of the coil and the depth of the location. This burner fries like an infernal rocket. Works on slopes. According to my feelings, the approximate power is 20 kilowatts. I'll go outside. There is a strong wind. Adjusting the flame with a tap does not work. Only a complete shutdown. The pressure gauge showed that the pressure inside the tank is very small. But I will put the pump in the tank later. Stopped by a crane, but it does not happen quickly. Can be used as a burner in a furnace or boiler. Use as an outdoor or camping stove. The application is limited only by the imagination. Friends who like the idea, like, subscribe, comment. I will try to release a new interesting video as soon as possible. Health and peace to you and your loved ones. Thanks for watching this video. See you soon, friends.